I got all the way through second grade before somebody thought to test my eyes and discovered I was legally blind. So it meant like the first 7 years of my life, I was just in a fog, and it had color, and it only had focus when it was 6 inches or closer to my face. I remember the day that I got my first pair of glasses, and it was the most incredible day and the most incredible feeling of my life when we left the optometrist and I saw what a roof of a house looked like, and I saw smoke coming out of chimneys, and I saw telephone wires, and these were things I'd seen in books, and so I just believed that they really existed, but it was incredible to see them. I remember seeing the tops of trees for the first time, and before that I'd only known the part of the tree in our front yard that I ran into when we were playing, so I started drawing pictures the next day at school of trees. And my teacher looked over my shoulder and said, "You're drawing trees better than I do." And I went home that night and dreamt I was going to be an artist. I was absolutely certain that music was invented just to torture me. I thought it was a terrible thing to waste your time learning an instrument until at 12 years old, we'd all watch Ed Sullivan while we were eating dinner. One day, you know, it's just the typical Ed Sullivan show, and the Beatles came on. And they played She Loves You, I think, and I Want to Hold Your Hand or something like that. And I just remembered, I said, that's why I've spent my whole life learning how to play music, so I could do that. When we first started Devo, Jerry and Bob and I, we were artists who were working in a number of different medias. We were around for the shootings at Kent State, and it affected us. We were thinking, like, what are we observing? And we decided we weren't observing evolution, we were observing de-evolution, and so we decided to write music about that. We were wondering, how do you change things? And we looked at Madison Avenue, and they were getting people to eat horrible food that they shouldn't eat and buy things that they didn't need. We thought, their techniques were the ones we wanted to use, so we packed up and moved to Hollywood and decided to become subversive. It was hard for us to adjust to it, coming from being art purists that had decided to enter the bowels of the entertainment world. The record company just kind of thought of us as this eccentric art band. They knew that David Bowie liked us and that Brian Eno had produced our first record. Then accidentally we got a hit, and that in some ways was a conundrum because it meant that the record companies then for the first time took an interest in us, and they said, do anything you guys want to do, just do another Whippet. I never thought about music as writing a hit song. We were just reporting the good news of de-evolution.